We're on page 11b, 10 lines from the bottom of the page, Ve'azdu leta'amayhu. This is a very special time because we just completed the celebration of Lag Ba'Omer, and therefore I would like to combine something related to Lag Ba'Omer with our sugya, which I strongly feel without background it will be hard for us to understand. So first, some words in regard to Lag Ba'Omer. Worldwide, meaning in a Jewish world, regardless to the affiliation, we chant the melody of Lag Ba'Omer with the song Bar Yochai, which applies to Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. It's a tradition that he connected to Lag Ba'Omer either by some view as his Yortzeit, as day of passing, or by others as a part of the act, the story of Rabbi Akiva and his disciples. But what is clear, either by the Sfaradim, who chanted it every Shabbat, and it's part of their prayer books, or by Ashkenazim, that they chant it either during the Shabbat meal, or at least on Lag Ba'Omer, it's a song that attributes to a great Kabbalist of the 15th and early 16th century by the name of either Rabbi Shimon Lavi or Rabbi Shimon Ben Lavi. And in that very Kabbalistic text, there is lines that said, Kav Yarok Mechadesh Chodashim. It speaks about creation. And in our discussion, our sugya yesterday and today, we entered the domain of disputation between Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Yoshua, when is the exact day the world created, either the view of Rabbi Eliezer that it was 25 days of the month of Elul, meaning Adam, the first man, created at the first of Tishrei, or by Rabbi Yoshua that this occurred at the first day of month of Nisan. So the notion of Kav Yarok, literally speaking, it's the green, light green line. It's according to the Zohar, this is the time of separation, which lucidly meaning the creation between Rakia and the Aretz, between the lucidly, literally, heaven and earth. So it means, according to the commentators on the Zohar, which I assume you know, one of them it's my great uncle and my great father, grandfather, they explains that it's a line that all the spirituality of the world, all the events relate to the metaphysical with the physical world, connected and has the cycle that in the yearly basis, and for sure there is an application also in the month and a daily basis as well, it's come and renewed. They call it in the Kabbalistic literature Sfirat Bina, it's one of the line of understanding, and that's which we call Mekif Olam, which means it's go around the world. And he used, Rabbi Shimon Lavi, or Ben Lavi, used the word Mekodesh HaKodashim, from the Holy of Holies. So that's based on the Gemara in Tractate Chagigah, page 12. The Gemara said that it's an act of tohu, act of darkness that the world faced in on a daily basis, or here for our discussion annually, when it's a decision make what's going to happen every single day of the year or every place in the world, and that's Bechinat Lechadesh, which means every day there is a quote-unquote green, light green line that creates a notion of anew. So for our discussion, we enter to Parashat Noach, the very beginning of creation, and we see the story of Noah and the ark. Noah entered to the ark, and he was there a year, full year. And the idea is that Noah entered to the ark not because the way that most of the people think that he was saved and he entered to be saved, but we understand that it was a punishment for Noah, meaning enter to that teiva, to the ark, was punished for him. And for sure this is not a Parashat HaShavua lesson, so we're not going too much with that. But the idea is that Noah entered, if you read carefully in the book of Genesis, you see that he entered by the second month on the 17 days, and he comes out a year later on the 27th day of the second month. So you have here 12 months, and we go by the solar year, which means what we count by the way that Shnot Chama, by the sun. And we explain that Din Resha'im Beginom Yud Bet Chodesh, the people who are wicked, they are punished in the act of Geinom for the full year. So basically it means that you have here an addition of 11 days, so we complete between 354 days to 365. So now we understand when they said in the book of Bereshit that Noah entered at the 17th day and left at the 27 days. Now it's another important point we read in Noah, that he sent a raven, he sent a dove, and it's basically for this discussion it's meaningless, because if you read carefully the text you see that Noah sent out a dove, and they have in her lip
olive branch,
thank you, and he's still there. And then the Torah said that when there's no longer water, charvu amayim, in the first Bachodesh HaRishon, he still stayed there for 2 months. So it means the rabbi said that it was a punishment for him to be in the ark. So if you look at the sentences, they said b'shivasar lachodesh hasheni, at the 17th day of the second month, b'shnat 600 shana lechayei Noach, at the 600 years of the life of Noach, b'chodesh hasheni, at the second month, b'shivasar yom b'chodesh, the 17th day of that month. So what does that mean, chodesh sheni, the second month? So this is the disputation. We learned that according to Rabbi Eliezer, who hold that Tishrei Nivra Olam, the world created in the month of Tishrei, the second month is the month of Cheshvan, and then by Rabbi Yoshua, who hold that Benisan Nivra Olam, the world created in the month of Nisan, then the second month is the month that we are now by Iyar. So according to Rabbi Eliezer, they have a great flood, Vayihi Geshem Al Haaretz, the tremendous rain on the land, and the Torah said 40 days and 49, and then at the very end of that perek, the Torah said Vayigberu Amayim Al Haaretz Me'a V'Chamishim Yom, it was 150 days that the water overflowed the land. And then they said Vayizkor Elokim Et Noach, that God remembered Noach, which we read during the Day of Remembrance, Rosh Hashanah. And then he sent the ravens, and he comes back, and sent the dove, comes back, you see 7 days. And then the Torah said, Ve'ibechad 600 shana, charvu amayim al haaretz. It was a time that the water began to
subside.
So you see here that it's a month, plus 27 days later. So you have here 40 days and 49. And you have the flood, another 150 days. So if you put together the numbers, which means that the water was altogether 190 days, which means you have a 6 month. And now how you count the month? We always go by Judaism, 1 month is full, Malay, which is the 30 days, and month that is Chasel, that is 29 days. If you calculated that, you have 3 times 29, which is 87, 3 times 30, it's 90, it's altogether 177 days. So if you add 13 days from 17 of Cheshvan up to Rosh Chodesh Kislev, and you count from the month of Kislev until the month of Sivan, you have altogether 6 months. So that's the time that the waters subside. The Torah said that 15 amam al rashi achim, 15 cubits above the top of the mountain. So meaning, at the 17th day of that month, when the water, v'amayim gavru meod meod, it was a tremendous amount of water that overflowed, and then it was 15 cubits, v'ichusu arim, that the mountain overflowed, and then the Torah said, v'tanach ha-teiva, and then the ark rested al hare Ararat, on the Ararat mountain. So if you look at the numbers, it's a 40 plus 150 days, which is 16 months plus 13 days. So what we understand that 17 days of the second month up to the first of the seven, that's the time that the waters subside. And then on the 17 days of the 7 months, the ark rested, and then when the water subsides, it's still not the time that Noah left, only but by the first day of the 9 months, which means when you're speaking about 15 cubits above the top of the mountain, it was an addition of 90 days until the water totally subsides. So meaning each and every day you have 1/4 of cubits, because you divided 60 by 15, you have a four, and then that day, which is the 17, the ark rested, which means this is the time that the ark is in the water 11 cubits, and then you pass 16 yom, 16 days, and 4 cubits, then they physically were able to see the mountain. And then, if you wrap it together, it was a month and a half after the water totally subsided. So we basically now understand clearly what Rabbi Eliezer tells us. What Rabbi Eliezer tells us, that Adam, the first man, meaning the beginning of the year, is the first of Tishrei, which means we go by that view, 25th day of Elul creation, first of Tishrei, the first man created. And then, ve'azdu le'tamayu, now we start to understand each view. The view of Rabbi Eliezer, which means from the first day of the 9 months up to the first day of the first month, the water subside, which means the land was charev, it wasn't a land, but it's not totally dry. You can say that it's a muddy, etc. And only the way that you look at the Torah, now you see that at the 27th day of the second month, then he, meaning Noah, walk outside. That's basically follow the way of Rashi. So we are 10 lines from the bottom of page 11b. The Tanya, this is Bereshit, Genesis chapter 7. Bishnat 600 shana lechayei Noach, at the 600 years of the life of Noach, Bachodesh Hasheni, at the second month, Beshiv'a asar yom lachodesh, the 17th day of the month, Bayom hazeh, in that day, they have a great flood, all the fountain of the great deep broken open, and the windows of heaven were open. So, here, is the disputation between Rabbi Yoshua and Rabbi Eliezer, when exactly that happened. Rabbi Yoshua Omer, Oto Yom Shiva Asar Be'iyar Aya. That day was the 17 days of the month of Iyar. Yom Shemazal Kima Shokeabo. This is the day that the consultation of Kima sets during the year. Uma Ayanot Mit Ma'atim. And the springs diminished. Umitoch Sheshinu Ma'asehem. Shina Kadosh Baruch Hu Aleihem Ma'aseh Bereishit, because the people of the great flood did not behave properly, so Hashem punished them measure for measure and changed the order of the creation. Ve'ela Mazal Kima Bayom Ve'natal Shnei Kochavim Mekima. I'll read it first and then I explain. Ve'evi Mabul Haolam. רבי אליעזר אומר, אותו יום 17 במחשוון היה, יום שמזל קימה עולה ביום, מעיינות מתגברים. So, first, according to Rashi, according to רבי אליעזר, he said, if you tell me that during the Nisan, the year switch, so when the Torah speaks about 150 days, that the water was over, and the first of the seven, which is the year 601 of the life of Noah, then the year change. So if the Torah debate between the first and the first of the year of 601 of the life of Noah, which means only in Tishrei the year change, and that's basically what she said in Dibur HaMatchil Ve'azdu LeTa'amayhu, which is three lines from the top of the page. רבי אליעזר ורבי יהושע דל רבי אליעזר בתשרי נברא עולם דמתשרי מתחיל מניין שתי הדורות. So you have הגהה, a comments at the very end of the tractates that elaborate on that, but at the very end of Rashi he said the same way, is that instead of Sivan we have the month of Kislev, so it means Nisan, this is the time according to Rabbi Yehoshua. Now when we speak about Galgal HaMazalot, the constellation. So in a very basic, simple way, there are 12 Mazalot. Each month have its own Mazal. And I purposely use the word Mazal in Hebrew, not the word of constellation, etc. Not the world of astrology. So each month have his own Mazal at the beginning of the dawn, Alot HaShachar. So there is a view here of Rashi and the Tosfot that unite in this view. There is another view of Tosfot in page 35a, Agaha, that goes differently. But I'm going now in the very basic way of Rashi and Tosfot here. Every day we have 12 Mazalot, which means you have 24 hours, and therefore it's divided to 12 times 2, meaning during the day we have 6 Mazalot, and in the night is another 6, which means the Maslul HaKochavim, the way that the stars go, the first one goes at the dawn, and therefore there is a reflection of each month. So for example, the month of Tishrei, we call it Moznaim. The month of Cheshvan, it's called the Scorpio, Akrav. The month of Kislev is the Keshet, the arrow. Tevet is the Gdi, Shvat is Dli, or Adar is the fish, is the Gim, etc., etc. So Iyar, for example, it's shore, it's ox. And Nisan is the Tale, right, is the lamb. So usually if you look at those books, they give you pictures, right, like the books that Dr. Bruce have all the times, right? So you see a map of the stars, and you see a picture of the ox, that you have the stars inside the ox, and on the tail of the ox you see a lamb, right? So over there you see a many stars. So that's called, in the rabbinic language, when you see that picture, it's called Mazal Kima, which means that is the constellation, is a group of stars that sit on the tail of the taleh, of the lamb. So meaning, if on the month of Nisan it's a mazal taleh, so at the very end of the mazal taleh there is ma'arechet kochavim, that is a set of stars, constellation, that it's called kima. And Rashi said, the way that we, in a Talmudic definition, it's called kima, meaning that's the tail, the very back. Now, in the month of Nisan, the first 2 hours, this is called meshamesh mazal taleh. The mazal taleh is served. And then 2 hours later, the taleh, the lamb, go up, and the pushim, the ox, so for 2 hours. And then you have the teomim, and then you have the next one, which means every 2 hours, there's one push the others. Which means if we say that the flood occurred on the month of Cheshvan, which means at the 16 days of Cheshvan, meaning 2 hours before the dawn, it was mazal taleh, it was the lamb, which means 1 minute before the dawn, this is the time that the tail of the taleh, the tail of the lamb, is in our understanding, that's the time that he was in service. And then right away the ox come instead, mazal shor, and push him. And then you have the teomim. Each of them push, and that's the way, one school of thought. There is another one that said that it was in the month of Cheshvan. So it go opposite. If you tell me that Nisan is the mazal taleh, is the time of the lamb, so down when it's dawn, you have Moznaim, which is Mazal Tishrei. Cheshvan is the Scorpio, is a crab. So then the lamp starts going up and the others go down 2 hours later. So you see here the cycle, which is Moznaim is the Tishrei in the beginning, and then the Taleh goes down. And during the day, that's the cycle is constantly changing. You have Moznaim, you have Akrav, the scorpion, then the Taleh, the lamb, goes down, the lower part of that mazal. So now we see when they use the term Ve'azdu le'tamai, when Rabbi Elazar and Rabbi Yehoshua go by the view, also in regards to the Noach Ark. So what they said in the line with the 600 years, etc., Rabbi Yehoshua hold that that day was 17th day of month of Iyar, which means, according to Rabbi Yehoshua, the world created at the beginning of month of Nisan, and therefore the act of the great flood happened on the 17th day of a month of Iyar. Yom shemazal kima shokeabu, the day that the kima, which is that day that the tail goes down, which means, and now you see umaya not mitmaatim, that the springs diminish with increased heat, and therefore, if you talk about summertime, then the tehom pochet, it's below. If it's a winter time, it's ole. Obviously, you see a flood in the winter time. So iyar, month of iyar, the taleh is going up. So instead, the ox come in, and then you have the teomim. So mazal kima is during the day. The Vilna Gaon goes very differently. And Vilna Gaon said that that's applied to chelek ruchani, that the spiritual part is diminished. But anyway, we go in the pshat, we go just by the simple way the Rashi tells us. That Rashi said anything, kol davar sheolech lekivun hashkeah, anything that goes toward the dawn, we call it shokea, we call it that it's about to dawn. Like, for example, you ask someone, what time is it now? So the person may say, we are now 7 hours from now will be shkia, will be a time of the dawn. So that's matbea lashon, that's the way people speak, that it's going about to say. So Tosfot said, in the Bura Matchil Yom Shemazal Kima Shokea Bo, so he said, that's the cycle. You have the shokea and you have the ole. You have the winter that the mayanot mit gabrim, that you have the spring water overflow. And now it's the crucial point. He says Guess what happened the time of the great flood? Because people behaved so horribly, shinu ma'asehem, people did all kind of immoral act. So therefore, God changed the creation in our language and created the great flood. So basically, what does that mean, great flood? So again, the way that the cycle works, it's like Hashem created a hole. The moment you have that hole, then it's a mess, it's a great flood. So now we go and we said, Bishlama le Rabbi Yoshua, mitoch sheshinu ma'asehem. So because they behave in such a manner, God, Shina Kadosh Baruch Hu aleihem ma'aseh bereshit, God changed the whole set of creation. So page 12, ומתוך ששינו מעשיהם, and because people changed the action for the worse, so God punished them measure for measure, שינה הקדוש ברוך הוא עליהם מעשה בראשית. God, blesses he, changed for them the act of creation. ואלה מזל קימה ביום, and he caused the constellation of קימה to rise during the day. And ונטל שני כוכבים והביא מבול לעולם, and God removed two stars from it and he brought the flood to the world. בישלמה לרבי יהושע, if you go by רבי יהושע, that said that the world created in the month of Nisan, היינו דכתיב שני. שני meaning is Iyar, the month that we are now, so it's the second month of the time that you count the months. אלא, so the Torah said Rishon ulachem lechodshei hashana, this is the first of the months, so we understand Ela lerabbi Eliezer mai sheni. So the Mar Cheshvan is not the second one, it's the eighth one. So the Gemara said no, sheni ladin sheni, it means this is an expression of the time of what Hashem already judged. בישלמה לרבי יהושע, היינו דשינה. So here we understand, according to Rabbi Yoshua, that Hashem changed the whole creation, which means usually kima is not coming in Iyar, and that's the time the ma'ayanot mitgabrim. So and God changed it. El Rabbi Eliezer ma'ishina. What exactly, according to Rabbi Eliezer, what changed? So Tosfot learned the opposite. The last line on page 11b, Tosfot said, "Bishlam al Rabbi Yehoshua al Rabbi Yehoshua ma'ishina." So it means that if you tell me that Noach entered at the middle of the day, so it means that was the exception, that Kima occurred at the middle of the day. But but when we go by the year, so we go by the year of the solar, so we basically have the season, which means year we go by solar year. Season, we said, we have four seasons, right? Winter, summer, spring, yeah, right, yeah. Fall, but in the Talmud they call it Tkufat Teivet, Tkufat Tammuz. That's the time that they call the beginning of the Mazalot. So therefore, the Alot HaShachar, the time of the sunrise, it can be at the middle of the day. We, in a way, Me'apsim Et HaYareach, we basically put the moon, meaning that the time of the moon sometimes, because if you go by the lunar way, so you have 354 days, plus few halakim, few points. And if you go by the solar, you have 365 plus 6 hours. So when you talk about the kufot, the season by the Talmudic, you go by the solar, not by the lunar, which means when you talk about the season, you speak about 91 days plus 7.5 hours, because you take, if you take 354 and you divide it by 4, it's 90, and the rest you basically take the 91 plus 7.5 hours. So when we say that Hashem Tala Morot Bashamayim, the Wednesday, the fourth day, Hashem put the lights in the heaven. So this is the beginning of the day. So the next year, in other words, if you go by that view, the year is Wednesday, that next year is Thursday plus 6 hours, which means the Tkufa, the season, start in the quarter of the time, either 6 or 12, because you take 365.6, you divide it by 7. So you see every season it's moved in 6 hours, and that's basically the season by Rabbi Yoshua, because he hold that the 25th day of Adar is the creation, which means Adam, the first man, created at the first of Nisan. So Kid Rav Chisda, Damar Rav Chisda, that's the response of Rav Chisda, that he said, even according to Abeliezer, it was changed. You know why? Here was something frightening. He said, Damar Rav Chisda, Berotchim Kilkelu, Uberotchim Nidonu. He said, with the boiling water, boiling heat, they seen, and the boiling heat, they punished. Berotchim Kilkelu, with the boiling sin, they did a sin, ba'avera, with the sin. What's the avera? They have this sexual prohibited relations, gilui arayot, sexual with a married woman, etc., and also by homosexuality, and in the language of the Torah, it's called ashchatat zera, that wasting the sperm, putting this in the ground. So that's called a hit in the Talmudic interpretation of the Torah language, and therefore uberotchim nidonu, as Hashem punished them measure for measure with a boiling heat of scalding waters. Why? Because they said here k'tivacha vayashoku hamayim. There it's written in the Genesis chapter 8, and the water abated. Uchtivatam, and they said in the book of Esther, chapter 7, Vachamat Hamelech Shachachat, and the heated anger of the king abated. So abated mean cool. So Achashverosh was cool. So you see here, by using that language, that changed the nation. Tanu Rabbanan, Chachmei Yisrael Monim Lamabul, Ki Rabbi Eliezer. So the as we said earlier, this Jewish sage just count the year from creation and the flood according to the opinion of Rabbi Eliezer, which means that we go by the from Tishrei. So you calculated the sun and the moon according to the opinion, Velatkufa ki Rabbi Yoshua, the sun and the moon according to Rabbi Yoshua, which is from the sun. Chachmei umot haolam, but the sages of other non-Jewish nations of the world, Monin Afla Mabul ki Rabbi Yoshua, they count both the years from creation and the floods according to Rabbi Yoshua, which means is from Nisan. So I explained in my book, we don't have enough time, but in my book, Rashi here said, Klomar leminyan shnut adorot matchilin minisan limnot. So, which means that they count even the Doro, the generation, and the Mabul, was the flood was a sign that you start from the month of Nisan. Next subject is Velay Rakot. Another point, that the last one, the Mishnah said, the first of Tishrei is the beginning of the year for the tithe of the vegetables. So we go by the vegetable that collected only after Rosh Hashanah. Tana, lirakot vilamasrot vilandarim. So we learn that it's for vegetables, for tithe, and for vow. Lirakot maninu. What does that mean, tithe? So they said, lemaaser yarak, for the vegetables, tithe. One may not take truma or tithe from vegetables picked after Rosh Hashanah. So they said, Hainu Masro, the same meaning as therefore the tithe. So what's the difference? So Tana de Rabbanan v'Ktana de Oraita. So Dagan, Tirosh, and Yitzhar, it's biblical. So grain, wine, and oil, it's New Year's, the first of Tishrei. V'litne de Oraita bereisha. So let the Tana teach the Torah law at the beginning of the Braita, and then you say the title of the vegetables that it's only rabbinic. Either the chavig or the akdima. So he used first something that is dear to him. So the title of the vegetable was dear, because it's rabbinic. V'tana didan, tana de rabbanan, v'kol sheken d'oraita. So the Mishnah, he mentioned that it is raised the beginning of Rosh Hashanah for the vegetables, even those that it's only rabbinic obligation. And for sure, a biblical decree, which means the first of Tishrei is the new year for the tithe of the grain, wine, and oil, which is biblical. Velitne maaser, why we use a plural, we should use singular. Echad maaser bayma, ve'echad maaser dagan. Regardless, is the animal tithe or the grain tithe. So both of them. Tosfot said that this braita follow in the Mishnah of Eliezer of Shimon that hold that the time of the animal tithe is the first of Tishrei. So velitne yarak, why we said a plural vegetable? So they said trei gavne yarak. There are two types of vegetables, two categories of vegetable. Yarak an egad, mi sheyaged. So the vegetable make of bundles before being sold from its bundle, and there is made of bundles that the time of tithing when the so again that's a when it's not tvuah, that not reaching that point, so you can eat it biblically speaking even without putting it tight, as long as it's not a permanent meal. So they said, Tanu Rabbanan, liket yarak erev Rosh Hashanah ad shelo tavo ha-shemesh, v'chazar v'liket, if one picked vegetable on the eve of Rosh Hashanah before the sun is set, and return and pick more vegetable, 12b, mishtavo ha-shemesh, after the sun set. So Tosfot brought a Yerushalmi that he said it has to be that the non-Jew collected later in Rosh Hashanah, because otherwise he can't have it. Can't have the Jew doing that during the fest, during the Rosh Hashanah. Ein tominu me'asrin mize al ze. So one may not set aside a truma and tithe from one to the other, lefi she'ein tormin u'me'asrin lo min ha'chadash al ha'yashan v'lo me'yashan al ha'chadash, because we not set aside truma and tithe from the new crop for the old, nor from the old crop for the new. So it's all go by tar lekita, the time that you collected. Im hayta shniya nichneset la'shlishi, if it was situation that the completion of the second year of the sabbatical year and the beginning of the third year, so whatever collected at the eve of Rosh Hashanah until the sunset of the second year, shniya, so that's already second, ma'aser rishon u'ma'aser sheni, shlishit, ma'aser rishon u'ma'aser sheni, but not the second time, not ma'aser sheni. So now, how do you know that the third year, the second tithe, it's not applied? So Rashi said that how do you know that those years doesn't have the second tithe? Menanemi, the Amar Rabbi Shua ben Levi, because it's written in Deuteronomy chapter 26, Ki dechale la'aseret ma'asaret v'otcha v'shana shlishit, when you complete the tithing of you grain the third year, shnat hamaaser, the tithe. So if you tell me that it's the year tithe, why do you need to, the Torah needs to call it שנת המעשר, שנה שאין בה אלא מעשר אחד. This is a year that they have only one tie. הכיצד, how come? מעשר ראשון או מעשר עני או מעשר שני ייבטל. So you have the first tie, and then you have the poor man tithes, which giving to one who is needy, and then you have the second tithe is nullified that year. So you have only one tithe from the second of the previous year. Or no, if maaser rishon yibatel, you may say that by the first tithe is nullified during the third year, and only one tithe will set aside, which is maaser ani for poor people's tithe. Talmud lomar. So therefore, we learn in the book of Bamidbar, book of Numbers, chapter 18, ve'el alvim tedaber v'amarta lehem, you should speak to the Levi, ki tikchum et bnei Yisrael tamaser, when you collected the tithe from children of Israel, asher natati lachem mitam benachalatchem, hikisho hakatuv lenachala, the sentence juxtaposed the tithe of the Levi to the inheritance. Ma nachala en lahefsek of maaser rishon lahefsek, the same way that the properties has no interruption, the same is that the first tithe that is given to the Levi, there is no interruption, it's taken every year with no stop. Tanya na me'achikit echale la'aser. Shana ashen bal maser echad. Hakeitzad is only one. Maser ishon maser ani, maser shni yibatel. Yachol af maser ishon ami yibatel, talmud lomar u ba'a levi. Kol zman sheba ten lo. Divrei Rabbi Yehuda, as long as he comes, you give it to him. So that's the third year, so it means that that's the first tithe applied to third year. Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov omer, no tzarich. Harei omer, the pasuk said, ve'el ve'intel ve'amata lehem, ki tichum bnei Yisrael demaser ha'shonet lachem mitam menachalatchem, ikisho ha'ketuv lenachala. The sentence compared to the inheritance. Ma nachala en lahefsek, the same way as the inheritance is no interruption, av maaser rishon lahefsek, the same way as the first tithe is no interruption. Now, the Gemara come to explain to us what we learned earlier, that certain things, the first of Tishrei is the beginning. Velandarim, the beginning, making about Tan Rabbanan, Mudar Anam, Mechaviro Leshana, Moneh 12 Chodesh Leyom. So if someone prohibited by a vow of driving benefit from another for a year, so he counts 12 months from day to day, which means you go from the day that the vow was taken. So it means whether he took a vow not to derive benefit from another year, or subject to someone else, vow prohibition, prohibiting to driving any benefits. Either way, if he said for this specific year, even it was one day, meaning that it was 29 days of the month of Elul, since the first day of Tishrei occurred, so it means that one day, it's already considering what? It's a year. Even according to one who hold that one day it's not considered a year, since in the case of vow, the person what? Since he accepted upon himself to suffer affliction, so therefore, so even he have a goal is accomplished, because he have sometimes, even a short time, that he suffer affliction, so he doesn't need to fulfill his vow. So Ve'ima Nisan, so maybe you tell me that the beginning of the vow started on the month of Nisan, that's Rosh Hashanah and not the first of Tishrei. Bindarim Alech Achar L'shom Ne'adam, you go in an anthropomorphic way, which means in human language, and people go when they come of vow, the first Tishrei of Rosh Hashanah. Nanatam, we learn in the Mishnah in Ma'asot, Hatiltan, which is the Mishnah in Ma'asot, the first chapter, the found Greek, Mishetitzmach. It begins to sprout almost immediately after it's planted. So Hatvu'ah, so it means when the sprout is seed, from the time that seed is sufficiently developed to sprout into another crop. Hatvu'ah, which is the grain, Ve'hazitim and olives. You have to bring the maaser, the tithe, when? Mishiyaviu shlish, when it's reached one third of the growth. Mai mishetitzmach, when is the matter that they need to grow? Mishetitzmach, lizraim, when they reach that time that it's ready developed, which means you have the seed inside, plant outside. Hatvuha ve'azitim. So we say that the others, the grain and the olives, yaviu shlish, when they have one third. Menani milo, what do we learn? Amar asim Rabbi Yochanan, amatu ba'mishmed Rabbi Yosef Glili. Amar kradeto, I said in Deuteronomy 31, mikesh yevashnim amoyet shashmita b'chaga sukot. When is the end of the 7 years, the time of the release, festival of Sukkot. And he said, Shnat HaShemitah, my Avidit HaBechag HaSukkot, Shminiti, the sabbatical year, what is to do with the festival of Sukkot, is the basic, it's 8 years. Elo Malecha, it's come to teach you, Kol Shavua Shavi HaShlish B'Shviit, Lifnei Rosh Hashanah, Atam Moenu Gmishah Shviit B'Shminit, which means any field that they bring one-third and 7 years before Shoshana, you treated it as 8 years. So since bring one third in the sabbatical year, it's considering Gidulei Shviit, and that's applied to the following. So Amar le Rab Zera le Rav Asi, Rav Zera, a challenge of Asi, and he said, V'dilma lo ayel klal, v'kamar achmana tishamed v'ezil ad chag ha-sukot. Maybe it means that they continue to apply until the festival of Sukkot for the 8th year. Lo segel adar dechtiv, because the Torah said in Shmot, in Exodus 23, v'chag ha-asif b'tzad ha-shana, mai ha-asif? What is the gathering, the end of the year? Ilai ma'chag ba b'zman ha-asif ayume, he said that this is the festival come of the gathering of the crop. So be'aspecha, that the aktiv, it's written clearly when it's gathered. So why it's twice? Ela mai ha-asif katzir, what is gathering meaning harvesting. The sages know that any grain that was full growth harvest, the festival of Sukkot, is known that have reached the one-third growth before Rosh Hashanah. The Torah said that's the end of the years, which means that that's indication that it's still subject to the halachot applies to the previous year. When it's come to vow, the Shulchan Aruch Yoredeah 2:17. When the meaning of vows understood in according to the ordinary usage of language by people, which place and time in which the vow was taken. So if one take a vow for a year, or accepted upon himself a vow for a year without further specification, he counts the year from the day that he took the vow until the same day following year, and therefore in the leap year they have an extra month. It's also subject to a vow. Shulchan Aruch Yoredeah 2:20.
Shuloim, Malachai, Shuloim, Malachai.